Let's take a look at another important function of the home button. Press it twice in quick succession to reveal the iPad's multitasking bar. This bar is an important way to get around more quickly on your iPad. Get into the habit of using it and you'll find your iPad easier to control. Using this bar, you can switch to a different app while the current one remains in memory in the background, meaning it doesn't quit, but rather enters a kind of suspended animation. Let's see how it works. I can pick the Notes app and open up the Notes app. Now, if I want to change to something else, double tap the Home button and pick another app that's open, say the calendar. Double tap, picking different applications. It's much quicker than trying to search for them amongst all your iPad apps. You can also quit apps from a memory by using the multitasking bar. So tapping on an app, any app at all, will set them all wiggling with yellow circles with a minus sign in them. Scroll across all the apps that are open, and if I wanted to close them and maybe free up some memory, I can just tap on them all to close them and just maybe free up some memory. Press the home button and they will stop wiggling. The multitasking bar also has another important function. It has some controls for managing your screen rotation and your playback of media. If you swipe the multitasking bar from left to right all the way, you'll eventually come to a set of controls. The appearance of the first button, which is this one, will depend on how you've configured the side switch options in the general settings screen. If you've configured it so that the iPad mutes when you push the side switch down, you'll see a rotation lock icon. Now I have that configured and I'll show you how to change that now. We go to settings, so I should be able to find it in here. Go to the settings, into the general, and if you scroll down the page, you'll come to an option, use side switch. Now you can change the way the side switch works by default. This one I have it set to mute, so if I push the side switch on the iPad will mute immediately. Or I can set it in lock rotation so that when I have my iPad in my favorite position, either landscape or portrait, and I don't want it to keep moving around all the time, I can lock it in one position, and that is lock rotation. So you change them that way, and I think it's just a general preference for yourself as to which way you go. The moment we'll leave it to mute, double press the home screen, let's go back to the controls. So the first icon, I have it, the side switch set to mute. So the icon down here now is the opposite function. This one, if I wanted to then lock the iPad, I could come to the multitasking bar and do it from there. So at the moment, it's unlocked. So if I turn my iPad any old way, it's going to keep changing from portrait to landscape. Very annoying. Or I can lock it down and the side switch is still configured to mute. If you've configured the side switch to lock rotation, so let's change it, go back to the multitasking bar, then that first button now becomes a speaker, and that's a way you can mute your iPad there. It's currently muted is off, or mute is on. The other way, I tend to leave it in lock rotation because you can mute your iPad simply by holding that top side switch down. It will mute it for you. So if we have a look, go back to the home screen and turn up the volume using the side switch. If I want to mute it, holding the side switch down again will mute it completely. Back to the multitasking bar and to these controls. Now after this button you'll see a slider for adjusting the brightness. So if you don't want to go through the settings and adjust the brightness from there, you can do it from the multitasking bar and adjust the brightness to however you like it. And after this you'll find buttons for controlling the iPad's playback. So there's a play button, left button, right button, so going left, play button, depending on what media is playing, You could go directly to your music apps and selecting a song, whatever you want to put in there. It will then play back, and you can start. You can control that playback by pressing the home button. Going to here, you can control the playback from here. The volume. There's also a volume for controlling your media. And in some cases, there is another button, which is an AirPlay button. And that's how I'm actually putting the iPad onto the screen. I'm projecting, I'm mirroring what is on my iPad onto the Mac screen. And we'll look into that a little bit later on, what AirPlay is and how you use it.